Hello students, this is Paramjit Singh again welcome you. These are free online physics classroom for the welfare of the students to beat the COVID-19. Continue your studies and beat the COVID-19. Physics is a very fascinating subject. Full of experiments, full of curiosity, and full of ideas. So again, I continue the electric field, concept of electric field, more insight to the electric field. So electric field means electric field strength. Electric field intensity, all three words are acceptable. Electric field means electric field intensity at some point, or electric field strength at some point. What is electric field? This is the force experienced by per unit test charge. When test charge is vanishingly small, infinitely small, approaching to zero. This we know now, our previous knowledge. So here one change, you will find that I have taken test charge Q0. This is the symbol normally we use Q0. Earlier it was Q, small Q. Now small Q0. So this is electric field force experienced by per unit positive test charge. So simply we can say E is equal to F by Q0. So we have this formula here also. Electric field is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by r square r. We know this. Now see, this is the point where source charge plus q is placed. At some distance from this point where source charge is placed, plus q naught test charge is placed. This is experiencing force of repulsion from left to right. This is the r distance between capital Q and small Q naught. Now see, if source charge is negative, what is the scene? At some distance, some charge plus Q test charge is present there. Now we are discussing the field by plus positive source charge and negative source charge. Although we have discussed in detail this direction and all these in my module number 1/7, R is distance. Both the cases is now clearly on the screen. If source charge is positive, what will be the configuration of the system, and if source charge is negative, what will be the configuration? So now Q, capital Q is source charge, Q naught test charge, F force and E field. So why test charge is considered to be vanishingly small, that is approaching zero? Because limit, we take its limit approaching zero, because it should not alter the or change the field produced by the source charge, which is intended to be measured. We have to measure the electric field at this point produced by source charge. Now further mathematical analysis, these are three axes, x-axis, y-axis and z-axis, and some charge is placed in this three-dimensional system. O is the origin. At origin, some source charge plus Q is placed. I have taken little larger sphere to represent the source charge. This is the point. Point P. coordinates are x, y, z. Some charge in red color, some charge is now placed. As soon as we place the charge, charge starts experiencing the force. Charge is test charge. And what is the unit vector along the force? This is r cap. Along the force. And position vector of point P is r. And this r is OP. OP is a vector represented by r, vector r, position vector. This is the setup of the source charge and test charge in three-dimensional system. Therefore, what will be the force on test charge by capital Q? Apply Coulomb's law, we get this, we already know in earlier modules. In module number 7, I have discussed all these expressions. Here just a difference is in small q, in place of small q, now I am using q naught as test charge. So this is equation number 1. Now we know, see this box, unit vector r cap is vector divided by its magnitude, that is vector divided as small r is magnitude. Now we can substitute this r cap from this value, vector r divided by small r. If we substitute, we get the formula of force in this form, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught capital Q small q naught divided by r cube. No, this is not r, this is vector r. See, this is our equation number 2. Further, but we know electric field strength is force divided by magnitude of test charge. This is equation number 3. Now compare 1 and 3, we get electric field strength at this point P, whose position vector is r, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by r square unit vector, r cap, from 1 and 3rd. If we compare 2nd and 3rd, electric field strength we get, compare 2nd with 3rd, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by r cube into vector r. So this is the discussion of electric field intensity due to a point charge in form of unit vector, vector analysis we have done. This is from equation number 2 and 3. Some more important remarks about electric field. Some more facts about the electric field. First fact, very interesting. Electric field is independent of the magnitude of the test charge. Because electric field is ratio of force to the test charge. If you increase the test charge, force will increase in same ratio. So ratio is always fixed. So electric field at any point of the source charge independent of the test charge. But why we take test charge vanishingly small? Because it should not alter the electric field produced by the source charge. Otherwise ratio is same. F over Q naught is same. If you change the test charge, if you bring test charge of higher magnitude, F over Q naught is constant, but you will not be able to calculate the electric field at that point correctly, because this large test charge will start changing, altering the electric field produced by the source charge. So on which factor electric field depends? This is independent of the test charge. So it depends upon the location of the point. If point is closer to the source charge, electric field intensity will be high. If point is away, far from the source charge, electric field intensity at that point will be lower, small. So two points I have discussed. Electric field is independent of the magnitude of the test charge, because this is a ratio. But why we keep test charge minimum or infinitely small, vanishingly small, approaching to zero? Because it should not alter the field of the source charge. This is the idea, to keep test charge minimum. Now what is next? We have seen that direction of electric field is along the direction of the force experienced by positive test charge. So when we place positive test charge in field produced by positive source charge, this will experience force outwardly. Therefore, direction of force in positive source charge will be outward. So direction of electric field produced by positive source charge will be radially outward. Radially outward. This new term we are attaching it, radially outward. And case of negative source charge, direction of electric field will be inward, radially inward. This point I will discuss later, this radially inward. Another fact about, now think the source charge is placed at the center of the sphere. Take imaginary sphere. All the points on the surface of the sphere are at equidistance from the center, and we know from this second point that electric field depends on the location or position. All the points are at same distance, so it means all the point which are lying on the surface of the sphere will have same electric field. So now if we draw lines from center to those points, you will feel that all the lines are radius. So therefore electric field is spherical in nature. Electric field is radial, produced by the point charge, whether this is positive source charge or negative source charge. It doesn't matter. Field is spherical in nature. Next point. No, so what is the electric field? This is the region around any source charge where another charge experiences force. This the region around the source charge. Now some more effects. To know more effects, we now navigate this website, amazing to watch. So I am trying to give you more and more experiences through animation, through videos, and focusing on the basic things, basic concepts. This will help you to build up the base. And if base is strong, you will be successful. So see, in this we have positive plus 1 nanocoulomb charge, this is minus 1 nanocoulomb charge, this is sensor to sense, these are some parameters we can control. So just we see the electric field from positive charge. I place this positive charge here. See, electric field is radial in nature, spherical in nature. See, and this is not only limited to the plane of the screen of my desktop. This is all in all the direction, all the direction. So when see this radial field is in all the direction, what type of picture you see? This is spherical picture. So see, outward, direction is outward. Now see, these arrows are bright, but as we move away from the source charge, brightness of the arrows reducing, it means that intensity of the field is reducing. See, I pick a sensor and put here. This is the direction of electric field at this point. I have put this positive test charge to check. If I put this, place this positive charge close to the source charge, see, this vector, length of vector increasing, that is magnitude of electric field increasing. If I take this positive charge more closer to the source charge, see, increasing, and electric field is inversely proportional to the square of the distance, see how fast magnitude increasing. See, this is going to infinite. If I move away this positive test charge, see what is happening, arrow diminishing, electric field becoming zero, to approaching zero. Practical, there is some limit where electric field becomes zero, but theoretically electric field becomes zero at infinite. This is another point of discussion, in detail we can discuss these points, what is infinity and all these points. So till now, just understand, practically electric field becomes zero somewhere, but theoretically it becomes zero at infinite. See this simulation. See. Now I remove this positive charge. Let us take negative source charge. See. Now direction of arrow reverted. Reversed. Inward. This is my positive charge of test charge I put here. Now see, arrow is inward. Again, if I move closer to the source charge, arrow increases, electric field increasing, and at some point very high intensity will be very high, infinite we can say, very large. If we move away from the source charge, see what is happening with this red vector. This vector is force, and direction of electric field from negative sources is inward, radially inward. See, radially inward, if I rotate here, radially inward, always force is directed towards the source charge. What will happen if I place positive and negative? Although this is not the aim of this module, but let us see what happens, just for the sake of curiosity. Now nature of the electric field changed, arrows and all these. See one more view. This is the distance measurement. See. This is the distance This is the point situated at 164. Exactly 160 centimeters. Okay. This is the point situated at 160 centimeters from the source charge. I put a sensor. This is the electric field. Okay. If I increase the distance, 300.1 meter. Now I place this sensor here. See what happened with the force. Reduced. Force reduced. My test charge is constant. I am not changing the test charge, neither changing the source charge, just distance. As we move away, how the distance is creating the impact on the electric field. So okay, this is the discussion we have made today through practical example. So let us move to, so we have watched this very good video, some activity is there. So now electric field and force. See, again I am repeating this, electric field is intermediate between force and charge. Electric field plays an intermediary role in the forces between two charges. We can write like this. It works both the ways. Arrows are both the ways. Source charge, test charge, electric field. Now variation of electric field with distance graphically. Practically we have discussed through this amazing to watch section. Practically we have observed this in amazing to watch section. Now this is the y-axis along which we take electric field. This is the x-axis along which we take r square. This is the origin, and see, this is the graph of variation of electric field with radius. And here what is the relationship? E is inversely proportional to the r square. So theoretically electric field extends up to infinity, because this is assumed that this graph will touch at infinity. But practically it is limited to a certain distance. So what is a spherical symmetry? I have explained this in detail through animation also. Through this activity we have conducted just in previous slide. Spherical, let us more insight to this spherical symmetry. So what is this? Spherical symmetry. It means the points which are at equal distances from the source have equal electric field intensity. This is spherical symmetry. The direction of electric field is always towards the source charge. This is spherical symmetry, radially inward or outward. This is spherical symmetry. In electric potential we will study this in another point of view also. So if source charge is positive greater than zero, see, this is what I want to tell you, radially outward. See, I have kept this source charge little big sphere, red sphere is source charge, positive here. Again I repeat, see, radially outward. This is positive charge, radially outward, the spherical symmetry of the electric field due to point charge. Now another section of slide, again positive charge. Now what is the difference between this and this? See, this is the field produced by positive charge. This is the field produced by positive charge Q dash. It implies that here field is more dense and here field is not as much dense as in this case. So what we can conclude? we conclude that Q is bigger than, larger than, greater than Q'. Now see what is in this box. If Q is negative, source charge is negative, then field will be radially inward. Field is spherical, this is spherical symmetry. We have placed a negative charge small as compared to this previous one, minus Q. Inward, radially inward. This is the meaning of radially inward. Electric field lines are approaching towards the negative source charge. Spherical symmetry. This is what is spherical symmetry. Now what are electric field lines? Although we have gone through this idea through lines and all arrows, lines, all these things. We have discussed lines through lines. But now, more insight to the electric field. How to manifest the electric field? How to understand the electric field? Some more concept. That is electric field line. So let the point charge be placed at the origin. I have placed this positive charge here. In another box, I have placed the negative charge at this point, origin. Now, we draw the vectors pointing along the direction of electric field and keeping their length proportional to the electric field intensity at that point. So the vector which is closer to the source charge will have longer length, because length of vector represents the magnitude. So see, in first case, see electric field lines. This is charge. This vector is longer than shorter, and last one is the shortest. Why these vectors are becoming shorter and shorter? Because as we move away from the source charge, electric field intensity decreases. Electric field is a vector quantity, we can represent it by vector in magnitude as well as direction. See, these are electric field lines originating from the source charge. Now in case of negative, see here again, size of length of the vector is again reducing, but direction is reversed, because this negative source charge has spherical symmetry and direction is inward. Electric field line. So what is the conclusion? The conclusion for positive charge, electric field is outward, radially outward. And for negative charge, electric field is inward. And these lines are electric field lines. We will define electric field lines in coming modules. But just understand the concept. Drawing the lines give the views about the electric field, about the strength of electric field, about the direction of electric field. And these lines are drawn along the force experienced by a positive test charge. And we are drawing according to the concept. We are keeping the length of the vectors according to the strength of the electric field at that point. So what is the magnitude of electric field? Electric field, magnitude of electric field, that is strength of electric field, is represented by the density of the electric field lines. If density is higher, electric field intensity will be higher. So now see, close to the source charge, what is the density? In smaller area, number of field lines are large. But if distance is distance of point is larger from the source charge, so if point is situated at larger distance, see, larger area but number of electric field lines are same. So electric field intensity can be understood in terms of the density of the electric field lines, density of these vectors. These vectors are electric field lines, representing the path of the electric field lines. Suppose representing electric field lines. So near to the source charge, density is high. Away from the source charge, density is decreasing. In both the cases, negative or positive. So, dear students, this module now completes, module number 8, and properties of electric field lines will be discussed in coming modules. Keep attending lectures, subscribe, like and share. Thank you very much.